I'm dripping on rags. Rip gon' be the tag. Do the digital dash. Yeah, I'm boasting, never brag. Please don't touch my rag. Or the Chris Van Nash. Alessandra Gucci Glass. The WN is in collab. Yeah, pop it like a like. Yeah, drop it on the. I'ma buy another. Cause the boys bring it back. Yeah, you know how to make it last. Plus, and plus, keeping tabs. I'ma fly first class. Wave will hit him with the. Please don't touch my wrath.
Don't step on my Russ Simmons. Don't step on my Russ Simmons. Don't step on my Russ Simmons. Do you know how much I'm spending? My closet, it worth about a million. Took a little off the runway. Next, in the kitchen. Ralph Simmons. All kind of crazy colors. Living color. Left wrist, roll it, ice. Made some Margiela my sweater. Margiela. Mama told me never sell them. Ralph Simmons, don't lace them. Ralph. Got your bitch, wanna.
Huh? What? Don't wanna talk about the papers. I swear to God, these got these behaviors. They be hating, I feel out of. Living cul-de-sac, don't get along. Ooh, right with my neighbors. Diamonds on my neck and roll it on. Now I later got on different flavors. Done with my lightsaber. Ooh, feel like Darth Vader. I'm a boss, so you know I might riff it. In my basement, yeah, but you know that I'm gonna face it. Wait, that's the reason that they mad. Cause Lil Uzi, yeah, he made it. Yeah, I would have rap for I made it. Yeah, I would have rap for I made it. Yeah, got that rap all in my basement. Yeah, yeah, once I got patience. Yeah, I'm famous. Yeah, put my side aside.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. We should have a good one on tap here today. It's the Redskins coming in at 9-3, going up against the Lions, who come in at 3-9.
We are just inside the Beltway, about 10 miles east of the Capitol Dome, as we come to you from FedEx Field here in Landover. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Detroit Lions and the Washington Redskins. On first down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he's able to get up here to the 26. A good first down call as the screen play gets him 9.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
Yeah, it was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
On first down, Griffin. Dancing to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. And the defense loses him. It's complete. How did he stay on his feet? And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. A huge play there for Washington. And even 70 yards. First and goal here from the 2. Now they'll run it on the toss. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
Second down, Griffin. And he will score. Touchdown, Washington. A great play there. His 25th touchdown. tying Emmitt Smith for the fifth most in one season. And the Redskins take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Will Lutz on for the point after. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this team. Lutz now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. Winner. This is Mark Ingram. Takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards.
It's really simple to say that they know their identity, that they are a passing team. But one of the reasons that they're so successful, they know how to mix in the run and make sure that they keep the defense off balance and not able to just simply say, let's go get the quarterback and disrupt things.
Second down, here's Garoppolo. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Michael Kendricks coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7. A few issues here on the offensive line. Apparently, he got sacked 5 times last week. They got to him here in the first quarter.
And I would think that running the ball would be paramount here because it's a different team they're facing, but they watch the film as well. So they'll take many of those same principles and try and apply them in this game to see if they fix what was wrong with them in the last game.
There's Garoppolo to throw. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there that brings up 4th.
Trust me, Brandon, I'm not about to try and take your job. I can't do what you do. But that wasn't just 3 and out. That felt like 3 and backwards.
That's exactly what it was. You can have my job whenever you want it. The drive that you're looking for, though, probably going forward, bad start to the ball game.
Yeah, not the way to get things going.
Nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And it'll be Redskins football now with a 1st and 10. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. As they run the counter play. Try to run inside, but nothing there. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
And if you're the defense and those D tackles, you like that they're trying to run the football here against your 4-3, don't you?
Yeah, because they tend to eat things up because they are so strong and physical, and especially when they play with leverage where they get lower than the offensive lineman and control them. And what I love about the good defensive tackles, they can play over the guards, they can slide and play over the center. Nobody in the offense likes that day when they have to deal with those guys.
10 yards still left on 2nd down. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41. He's able to rattle off 6 on the carry, and that'll get him to 3rd and 4.
You and I have talked about it before, but what about the year this guy's had on the ground? You come in as a rookie and in the discussion as MVP.
And people have always told me, running back, one of the easiest positions to break in, but not to this level. If you're talking MVP, that means he's had a sensational season. Well, it wasn't a big strike, but that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now, 4th and inches?
Yeah, it's not more than a 1/2 foot.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I'm one of those guys.
It'll be a pickup of 4, and it'll be 1st down Redskins. Time running out here on the play clock. On first and 10, it's Griffin. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. From midfield now, here's Griffin. Being chased out left. Oh, the rookie nearly had the pick. Probably should have had it. Third down now. Pretty lucky to get the football back. Had his target out there waving the arms, saying I'm open, but maybe didn't see him quick enough.
And I know the jokes are always about defensive backs' hands. What really actually happens, you don't get many opportunities. You get over-anxious, and you start to think about taking it away and going the other way instead of focusing and catching the ball.
They send Stills in motion. On third down, Griffin. First down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. Back live, Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Redskins. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Oh, now he bowls him over. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
And an alley to run. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20. And now the Lions going to stop us momentarily as they call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Now the offense lining up first and 10. Throw it with Griffin. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Keanu Neal. And the return will stop them well inside their own 20 at the 15-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
That good for 22 and a first down.
Outside handoff to the right side. If you're a running back, you love getting the ball early so you have vision to see what's happening in front of you.
Right tackle likes that call. Big play for him. But don't forget about the guys you always tell me on the backside sealing off.
And they talk about cutoff blocks, making sure no one can leak from the backside that can run a play down.
Yeah, nobody leaked. Big play. He goes underneath to Ingram. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll make it a second down.
Here we go.
Looking to throw, Garoppolo. Caught, it's Ellington. Give him 30 yards there.
Trying to defend a drag route is really tough because you don't want to jump a route that's shorter or underneath as the drag route is too quickly, because oftentimes they want to run that route and then hit over the top of you for bigger yardage. So if you can chip off the timing of the receiver off the line of scrimmage so he can't actually get into the route, that's the best way to defend it. But there was no possibility of that on that play. End result, receiver won in a big way.
Second down, Ingram. And he'll be taken down just shy of the red zone at the 21. Pretty good running there, 9 yards. Sets up a third and one.
this drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense.
Ingram churning. He lost the football. And the Redskins scoop it. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Two minutes to go here in the first half. Back to FedEx Field following this short break. And the offense moving in the wrong direction here now as they face a second and 12. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. He lost two there. And it's third down.
Muhammad Wilkerson elevated a Temple program that was looking for players like him, and he's carried that on into the NFL. What a terrific play there.
Yeah, nice tackle for loss for the former Temple Owl, as you said, and the 30th pick in the 2011 draft. Third and long, it's Griffin. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
This is Ingram on first and 10. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
To throw, it's Garoppolo. And that's complete. It's Allington. And he is knocked down from the side at the 18-yard line. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on it and then let him run.
Right, he's got some space. It's complete. Flaner, right side. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. I know when you got a top tight end like this, you want to get him involved, but when you do, you're hoping for more than that.
You certainly are. You've got to try and get him some space where he can make a play downfield, or at least an opportunity for some rack yardage, right? That run after catch.
3-19! Now Garoppolo throwing on second. That is caught at the 7-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense, as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. And here we go on first and goal. They'll run here with Ingram. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. Wasn't able to get anything, no gain. Fumbled once already. Maybe he's being a little careful. Not necessarily on that play, but I'm sure that's in his mind somewhere.
Oh, without a doubt, because protecting the football is job one for anyone who's carrying it. And that's exactly what he tried to do on that play. But it didn't gain him any yardage.
Second down. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock.
I'll tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
A first scoring update now from Carolina, and it's an early lead there for the Saints. Tyrod Taylor with one touchdown pass thus far. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. From the gun, Garoppolo. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. It's complete to Flaner. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage. Back at the 43-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I saw Von Miller in college at Texas A&M, and all I kept hearing about was his speed off the edge to the quarterback. But what impressed me, his balance and his ability to take on blocks and be a force in the run game, as we just saw there.
They run. It's Mark Ingram. And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. He's got Sanu. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. That one goes for 29 yards on third down. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Defense went 3-4. They got some push from the inside.
And this is something in a 3-4 you don't normally get, because the nose tackle who got the sack, he's usually responsible or ends up getting double teamed and sometimes triple teamed. How about him working his way back and putting the big guy on the ground?
Getting it out left side to Sanu. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Garoppolo. Left side and caught by Flaner. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. They do get 9, but it leads to 4th down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. A 10th carry here for Mark Ingram. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Mark Ingram. Touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Lions have tied it. If they hit the extra point, they'll have the lead. And that one puts them on top here in the third. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fairly short kick, taking it to 14 here. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and 11.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
A gain of 13 and also the first down. They go play action here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
On second down, they'll try and run the counter. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Back now at FedEx Field. This one's still anybody's ball game. It's a one-point difference here as we begin the fourth quarter of play. The Redskins on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 16. From the shotgun, Griffin. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off near the 34. And he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line. Well, that's 3 picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are
season
in December.
Of giving.
Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. The Lions on 3rd down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 9. Now Garoppolo. And brought in here by Flaner. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a 4th down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
And he's going to have the 1st down at about the 38.
It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Now a handoff to Ingram. And oh, a good hit there and knocked down hard. Looks to be right around the 40. It'll wind up being a loss of 2. And that'll make it second and 12. Throwing now is Garoppolo. And his pass incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. From the gun on third, Garoppolo. And the Redskins do get to him. He goes down for a sack. Von Miller in there for sack number 85 of his great career, moving him past Hall of Famer Howie Long on the all-time list. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Garoppolo. It's caught. Nelson. 22 yards on the pickup there. And it's good enough for a Detroit first down. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary. Figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
And they've got it in the red zone now, down at about the 19. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 3. Again, they'll run with Ingram. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. The Redskins looking for another timeout, and they get it. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Back to throw, Garoppolo. And the tight end has it. It's Flaner. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Kobe Flaner, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Lions are able to grow their lead.
Well, that was absolutely ideal for them, wasn't it? Trying to salt this game away. I think one of my kids just graduated in the amount of time they had the football. That was absolutely impressive.
Everybody wants those salt away the game drives. What makes them successful?
Well, when you're able to mix run pass, when you're able to control the football and stay ahead of the chains, I'm using every cliche I know, but that's how you get it done, because you're not taking negative plays, and that way you're able to run what you want to run when you get a chance to call it.
And here come the Redskins now. They're down here in a 1-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
He's back to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll make this a 2nd down. They'll look to throw. And he hits his target. It's Kenny Stills. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. 1st down and 10 now for the offensive group. Back to throw. Throw right side, caught by Davis. 19 on the last play, 19 more here, and another 1st down. 1st down now, but that clock rolling.
All right, they picked up yardage, but they've got to get up to the line of scrimmage and spike it. They've got 1 timeout left. Want to save it.
Eluding the pressure right. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen.
And he gets in just in the nick of time, so they get the touchdown they need. Now they need a two-point conversion to tie it.
So they got the touchdown they needed to cut this to two, but now they've got to get back to the huddle. No celebration time. Got to figure out what they're going to do on the two-point conversion.
He'll look to throw. And it's caught. And with it, we are tied here in the fourth. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. So out now come the Lions. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. In a tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. Now Ingram, he's been busy today. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Here we go now. Green.
Room here to run. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. Now the Lions offense, they get ready to head back out there. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
And it's been loud in here so far. Back to the ground, this time with Ingram. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. A gain of a yard gets them back where they started. Now it's 3rd and 10.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
The Lions on 3rd down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This will be 3rd and 15. First throw of OT for Garoppolo. Let's it go for Nelson. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they finally get him down at the other 46. A huge play there in overtime, and even 40 yards. Two minutes to go here in overtime. We'll be back after this.
Here we go now.
Garoppolo now, first down throw. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. The Redskins looking for another timeout, and they get it. They'll be left with just 1 remaining here at OT.
Let's go.
On 2nd down, here's Garoppolo. He goes underneath to Ingram. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. It'll be a two-yard gain, and they're going to be staring at a third and long here.
Detroit! Detroit! Here we go now!
From the gun, it's Garoppolo. Now he's forced out right. Now he'll let it go deep. And this will be caught! It's a touchdown! An absolute stunned silence here as they have come in and stolen this one in overtime. A partner, great game that we got to see and making it extra special. Not only did I get four quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later.
You really